Hey guys, it's Dora from Ultimate Success Coaches. What's up? How are you doing? I hope great out there. Today's topic is something which has not been on the channel yet, and that's running shoe rotation. Yes, something around running, which I will restart tomorrow, luckily. If you have to put some emphasis on something running, that's a running shoe, because of course it can cause a lot of injuries if you don't have the proper pair of running shoes. And most people have one pair of running shoes, and that's fine. I had many, many years and I also had one pair of running shoes, maybe two if I had some extra money, but I was so many years a university student and just started with work, you know all these stories. And it's totally fine. Make sure that you have one good pair of running shoe. If I would recommend one pair of running shoes, that would be a daily trainer, where you can really do your running training on a daily basis. And that's a shoe what has enough cushioning, and it's really protecting your legs in the right size, in the right type of foam, what is suitable for your legs. If you are not sure, just go out for a local running store, get it checked out. Basically, they have also the treadmill to really try those shoes. And at the really good running shoe stores, they also offer a policy that you can try those shoes for certain, like 30 days or so. And if you are still not satisfied, then you can just take it back and change it. So I also had a video that first pair of running shoes. I will put the link above there. And that first pair of running shoes, I was recommending the New Balance 1080 medium. I would say it's not a super soft, but it's also not a firm landing shoe, giving really enough comfort and really enough protection for your legs. And this is the version 10 from 2019, end of 2019, beginning of 2020. So it's already a version 11 out there. I don't have that one, but it's similar with a little bit of upgrades. On this one, you can do 80% of your trainings. And if you don't have the means to buy a second shoe and you don't want to, you can do all the trainings as well. I had the version 6 and I used that also for marathons. Perfect, nothing crazy. This is quite bulky, I have to say. It's 250 grams in my size. So for those really tempo day runs, it's a bit bulky and you will feel that it's just not picking up the pace so easily than, for example, a tempo day running shoe. But of course you can do it, it just goes for all those kilometers. So even if you have the means and you make the choice to buy more pairs of running shoes, then one of the running shoes would be a similar daily trainer like this, where you can go, even if you would like to go, you can go for those long runs, steady pace runs, which is bulk of your running trainings. You can also go easy in these shoes, but if you have, then go for also an easy day shoe with a max cushioning. This is not a max cushioning, of course. And why would you go for more pair of shoes? First, they say so many years long that your shoe needs some rest days as well to really get back on the cushioning side. I'm running for 18 years now. I wouldn't say that I really experienced it myself, that putting the shoes on the shelf for 1-2 extra days, it's coming back better, but there would be some researches, I would say, so I didn't show those researches myself. So this is one of the reasons. And the second reason is not all the shoes are meant to be used for the same purposes. I just mentioned this is not the best tempo day shoe. This is also not a max cushion shoe. I will put you out there a 3-pair running shoe rotation, which is, I would say, currently my favorite. And I'm of course training for a full Ironman, and I do some half Ironmans, half triathlons as well. So that's why I'm really going for a direction which is for the more cushioned shoes. So this is the daily trainer in my rotation. And besides that, I would say a second pair of shoe is a max cushioning shoe, because I have really some easy days when I go easy and I need as much protection as possible. And my current favorite on those days is the Nike Invincible, which came on the market in 2021. I would say it's currently one of the best shoes of Nike, next to the Vaporfly, next to the Alphafly, which are of course race day carbon plated shoes. This is really a max cushion shoe, full ZoomX midsole foam. Also, I had the review up there. Love this, absolutely marshmallows. More than 100 kilometers in, still the outsole is fine. Still almost no use seen on this one. Yep, easy days. Also, you can use this for a daily trainer if you like more cushion on your daily trainers. But I would say for me, that's really the easy day. And the surf pair, I'm not putting in the rotation as surf pair carbon plated shoe, because carbon plated shoe usually you use for race days, and how many race days did we have the past 1.5 years? Not too many. And this was my favorite anyway in 2020, and that's the Saucony Endorphin Speed. I ran my only marathon also in 2020 in this pair. Not carbon fiber plate, but there is a plate in it. Super for tempo days, also quite soft landing. That's why I like it, because it just gives that extra protection for my legs. So even on those tempo days, interval days, usually for me it's intervals between 500 meters and 1 mile. This is what I'm doing. I'm not really running on the track, and I'm not doing 200, 400 and such. So this is for me usually the interval days, the tempo days. Also use this the past months for long runs. Super also for the long runs. If you would like some tempo on your long runs, you can also use, I mentioned, the daily trainer for your long runs. It also does the job, but the Endorphin Speed really gives you more edge on those tempo longs. So this is my three shoe rotation, and I would say if you are training for a shorter distance, like a 5k or a 10k, and you also don't really want any plated shoe in your collection and on rotation, comes something else, and that's also from New Balance, but just received this a few days ago, so didn't really test out yet, just had one easy short run in this, so that's why I don't have any reviews yet. And this is the New Balance Rebel version 2. I'm super interested. It's just crazy soft. It's crazy soft. They say also that the durability is not top because, of course, this softness. Really interested how this will go for the 100 kilometers. So if you are training really for shorter distances, tempo days, it's just also super lightweight. I can really recommend this. And if you also go for the distance, half marathons, marathons, and you really want a carbon plated shoe, and if you have the means for that, because these shoes aren't be cheap, no surprise out there, Nike Vaporfly. This is still from 2020 version 1, next percent. Also, so many videos, so many reviews. Love this shoe as well. So this can really go for that race day or marathon, half marathon distance. So this would be my running shoe recommendation for a rotation. You had several options, so three basic shoes and two extras, and there's a fourth and fifth pair. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I would like to just mention, I have also a triathlon beginner's guide available. I will put the link in the description box below. And if you have any great suggestion as your current favorite in running your shoe rotation, let me know, put in the comment below. Thank you very much until watching the end, and see you in the next video. Bye!